Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event, the moment of truth, the one you've all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, proudly brought to you by Ladbrokes. Introducing first from Perth, Western Australia, please welcome the steamroller, Stephen Mr. Kennedy.
She said, I've seen you in here before. I said, I've been here a time or two. She said, hello, my name is Bobby Joe. Meet my twin sister, Betty Lou. And we're both feeling kind of wild tonight. You're the only cowboy in this place. And if you're up for a rodeo, I'll put a big Texas smile on your face. I said, girls, I ain't as good as I once was. I got a few years on the mountain. But there was a time back in my prime.
Steve the Steamroller Kennedy, the middleweight Hex title on the line as he goes up against Brian Ebersole. 30 fights, 22 wins, 8 losses, and this should be a cracker here, Dom.
Steve White, it doesn't get much better than this. The master versus the apprentice, same height, same weight, a plethora of experience, almost 100 fights between the two, Stephen. This should be an absolute cracker of a contest.
Last fight was at UFC 193 for Steve Kennedy, lost by decision to Richard Walsh. And before that, it was at UFC Fight Night 69, first round loss by rear naked choke to Peter Sabota. It's his third time appearing at Hex, and he hopes to make it third time lucky in terms of the Hex middleweight title.
Well, this bout has an extra element of a different dimension of animosity to it as well, Stephen. There was a little bit of animosity and some bad feelings in the lead-up to this, so very, very interesting to see how that plays out in the fight.
And his opponent, fighting out of Bradley, Illinois, US of A, via way of Phuket in Thailand, the ex-UFC fighter, please welcome the All-American American, Brian Ebersole.
She said, I've seen you in here before. I said, I've been here a time or two. She said, hello, my name is Bobby Joe. Meet my twin sister, Betty Lou. We're both feeling kind of wild tonight. You're the only cowboy in this place. And if you're up for a rodeo, I'll put a big Texas smile on your face. I said, girls, I ain't as good as I once was. I got a few years on.
Brian, the All-American American Ebersole, coming out of retirement, retired last year, middle of June, after his last UFC tilt, after he lost by a knee injury to Omari Akhmedov. And he's come out of retirement to face Steve Kennedy here at the Hex middleweight title fight at Hex 6 here tonight.
Yes, Steve, this will be a one-time only fight for Ebersole, according to all accounts. Really coming back to, I guess, settle some sort of score with Steve Kennedy. This should be very intriguing.
Well, 70 fights of experience, and, well, you can't really get much more experience than that. I don't think you'd have to be up there with all-time leading fighters in terms of fights fought. And at the professional level, made his MMA career start back in February of 2000. So 16 years of professional mixed martial arts experience with that man.
Known for his unorthodox striking technique, strong cardio, and incredibly strong wrestling base, both offensively and defensively. He actually baited Steve Kennedy into trying to take him down, Stephen.
And
dared him to.
Well, the arrow, Rallis Anonymous, Maybe it should be pointing the other way in terms of if he's wanting to take him down. But it's Ebersole and Kennedy for the Hex Fight Series middleweight title. Let's go down to Perry Kale for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, these two warriors now step into the cage to go toe-to-toe in the oldest proving ground. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event of the evening. It is now time to separate the men from the boys. Sanctioned by the Combat Sports Board of Victoria. Board members, Simone Bailey and Mal McGuinness. Our recorders of tonight's fight, Thomas Nicole and Phil Whiteman. Our physician at cage side, Dr. Naomi Harris, and our timekeeper, Chris Anderson Jr. Our judges at cage side, Albert Chen, Shane Byrne, and Mr. David Deversa. Proudly brought to you by Ladbrokes. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from a sold-out Hex Arena, live on GFL TV, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it's fight time! 3x5-minute rounds for the undisputed Hex Middleweight World Title. Proudly brought to you by Ladbrokes. Introducing first to my right, fighting out of the red corner, training out of Kick-Ass MMA, this man is a wrestler. Official weight, 83.7 kilograms, standing 5 feet 11 inches tall. Ladies and gentlemen, he has a fight record of 30 fights for 23 wins, 16 inside the distance. Fighting out of Perth, Western Australia, please welcome the Steamroller, Stephen Mr. Kennedy! And his opponent to my left, fighting out of the blue corner, training out of Tiger Muay Thai and Kimikai MMA. This man is a wrestler and Muay Thai fighter. Tonight he's wearing the red shorts with a white trim. Standing 5 feet 11 and a half inches tall, official weight 84 kilograms even. He has a overall professional fight record of 68 fights, 51 wins, 25 by way of submission and 8 by way of knockout. Fighting out of Bradley, Illinois, US of A, by way of Phuket in Thailand. Please welcome the All-American American, Brian Ebersole. Fighters, to center cage, please, for final instructions.
Gentlemen, we've been through the rules. You need to protect yourselves at all times, obey my instructions at all times. So have a good, clean fight. Touch gloves now, back to your corner.
All right, folks, the judges are ready, the fighters are ready. Hex Arena, it's time to make some
noise. Greg Glengeon's our referee. And here we go. Middleweight title on the line. Steve Kennedy, Brian Ebersole. Let's do it.
I don't know about you, Stephen White, but I'm excited.
I think everyone in this party is on the edge of their seats. Ebersole in the red trunks, Kennedy in the black and white. Early head kick to start here from Kennedy.
Kennedy with a relaxed sort of striking style. Like to sort of relax his way into his combinations and throw some random kicks as well.
And then Ebersole, known for his rather eccentric MMA personality, has a punctuated by the arrow on his chest, but also cartwheel kick knockout.
Oh, attempted takedown there,
Forrester,
completed
yeah.
by Steve Kennedy.
Yeah, caught the kick, straight down he goes, and straight in to half guard of Brian Ebersole.
Kennedy very, very handy on the ground, has a very, very heavy top game, Stephen White. I wonder if that's going to have a bearing on this now that Ebersole's on his back. Traditionally, we've known that the wrestler on his back or people with a strong wrestling background tend to be uncomfortable on their back, but Brian Ebersole's no ordinary wrestler.
Kennedy content just to keep it in half guard and rain shots with that right hand from the top.
Kennedy's also looking to work the body there to see if he can open up the top end there, the head. Ebersole's happy to sort of just work in underneath there.
And Kennedy now looks like he's trying to pass, get more shoulder pressure on the chin of Ebersole and pull that left leg through.
Trying to push on that knee to get that on Ebersole's knee to get his left knee out here so he can move into a half mount position or a mount.
And the shot's more annoying than doing much damage, but nonetheless, it's distracting Ebersole from, or attempting to distract him from the pass, attempted pass of Kennedy.
Ebersole moving the hips well in that half guard, creating that movement to sort of allow for some space to him to. For him to get up and scramble.
Well, Ebersole with 70 fights experience, so not an unfamiliar position for himself. Short shoulder shot there from Kennedy. And
you can also see with Ebersole's left foot there, he's really manipulating Steve Kennedy's left leg there and trying to really have more
head and arm choke. Looking for a head and arm choke. This could be it.
He's going to struggle with that without getting to the passing guard and being on that side control for that head and arm. So looks like Ebersole's happy to ride this one out, pretty relaxed.
Answering the phone as well.
Yep, in an attempt to defend the choke, Ebersole needs to get his right hand over his ear in what we call answering the phone, defends and opens up that right artery and defends against the choke there. So Ebersole pretty much knowing where he needs to be here and waiting for Steve Kennedy's next move, really, Steve.
Just a shade over 100 seconds left in the first. And we can see here, Ebersole, as you mentioned, opening up that attempted head and arm choke. Now trying to slip underneath Kennedy.
Nothing definitive yet on the ground from Steve Kennedy here.
But, well, that's it. Looked like he was waving the fight off, considering the last couple. I was a bit nervous, but we're back on the feet. A minute left in the first round.
It's like Ebersole's conserved his energy here as well. Kennedy hunting the head with that roundhouse kick.
Oh,
nice body shot. Cracking sound of that. Ebersole a little bit straight up. A little bit heavy on his feet.
Kennedy now. See the confidence now coming forward with those body kicks. Ebersole content to counter strike.
Kennedy just stalking the wrestler here, which is going to be very interesting to see if Ebersole wants him coming to him so he can enact a takedown. But,
Ebersole, nice move. Went for the takedown, finished with the uppercut.
Fakes the takedown and goes the uppercut there, Steve. Very hard to cover both bases.
Ooh, wheel kick there from Kennedy wasn't far off.
Spinning heel kick there attempts. Ebersole looking to do some unorthodox things.
And that's the end of the first round. Your thoughts on that one?
I thought that was a pretty nebulous round in that first period there, Steve White. I think, aside from that takedown, there wasn't a lot of definitive action there. No really significant strikes landed. Have to probably give that to Steve Kennedy by a whisker.
Yeah, it was. Let's listen in on Ed Babylon.
After he kicks you is when you strike, okay? Let's not initiate that kick, okay?
His or mine?
Yours. Do not throw your kick, okay? In and out, crowd him. We need that elbow coming forward, okay? But also up and down, all right? Up and down, up and down. I don't want you kicking that front leg.
So final words of instruction there, going into the second round from Ed Babylock. And we're set for action, round two. Big hello to everyone watching on Go Fight Live TV, GFL.TV on the stream. And here we go, round number two.
Let's see if one of these fighters can actually stamp their authority on this fight here, Steve Kennedy. Looks like a pretty even slate thus far, I should say.
But Kennedy has, from where I sit, the better of the ring control. Seems to be cutting Ebersole's angles off.
Oh, that's a cracking left hand.
Ooh, we stepped into that, did Ebersole. Stepped into that one as well.
Instruction from Ebersole's corner was to counter off Steve Kennedy's kicks. So let's see if he can put that into play here.
You can hear the excitement of Coach Ed Pavlock in the corner of Ebersole. 1-2 there from Kennedy. A kick of his own there from Ebersole.
Looking to stuff Kennedy and close up that distance, see if he can bring some dirty boxing in play here. Nice little attempted foot sweep from Stephen Kennedy. Can he take him down again?
Ebersole just heavy on his hips, trying to prevent the takedown there of Kennedy.
Kennedy slips around to the back. Very crafty.
3.5 minutes remaining here in the second. And the Hex middleweight title fight on the line between Stephen Kennedy and Brian Ebersole.
That's it, good. On your left.
And again, similar to predicament where we were in the first round.
Once again, Kennedy trying to get that knee out of that half guard position to really get some dominance here. Whoever the very seasoned Ebersole.
Get him on your front.
Holding
your
forward.
Get your knee. Move. Come on, son. Come on.
Trying to hold on to the leg of Kennedy and slip underneath.
Kennedy looking to step out to side control. Ebersole has locked that up there with tension from that foot.
Kennedy's got control of the head of Ebersole. The 2.5 minutes remaining here in the second. And this one's been a real grind fest in terms of strategy here from Steve Kennedy.
Quite the human chess game thus far, Stephen White.
Frame.
We can hear the instructions from Ebersole's corner.
Oh, Steve Kennedy attempting a big shot with that right hand.
Trying to build a frame and scoot his hips out, at least get to full guard. Richard Ebersole wins over Chris Lytle, Carlos Newton, and Dennis Hallman, most famously when he got $70,000 for getting trunks off of TV. Very memorable bout back in 2011, and Greg Legends has decided he's had enough, and he's going to stand them back up. So, over 100 seconds remaining here in the second. And the crowd urging both fighters on. Kennedy throwing those head kicks at will.
A couple of good shots there from Kennedy. Ebersole really needs to step this up to get himself in the eyes of the judges in a favourable position.
Has been all Kennedy thus far.
Ebersole looked to be going second, looked to be the more passive participant of the two. Really needs to start initiating some aggressive striking, and maybe even goading Steve Kennedy into a takedown.
Went upstairs, decided to go downstairs, and then ended up in the clinch. And just walks Kennedy over to the cage. Under a minute remaining here in the second. Almost identical to the first, as we mentioned before. And
Kennedy pushes him away, maybe looking to strike here. Oh, and that's a big shot.
Big shot there from Kennedy.
Big shot.
Ebersole, similar to Frank Trevino early in the night, just urged him, come on.
That's all well and good, Steve, but Ebersole really needs to create some action and some opportunities of his own here.
Exactly right. He's on the back foot. in more ways than one, not just on the judge's scorecard. Kennedy looks for it.
Oh, nice overhand right there. Really starting to work some punches off that clinch, I think, is really the key here for Ebersole for the rest of this bout.
20 seconds left in the second. Yeah. Kennedy again with that body kick. He's been throwing, and Ebersole with one of his own. And a bit of a smile there from Kennedy, and that will do it.
A little bit of showmanship from Ebersole there.
Well, a bit frustrating if you're from the perspective of Brian Ebersole, really not able to mount anything. Kennedy, on the other hand, has controlled the fight from the outset.
Definitely the work rate is different between these two competitors. We can see Steve Kennedy initiating more of the striking, completing two takedowns now. He's very, very smart step around from the back here. He noted that his stance was wide, so he just pulled out that post with his own leg. So some very, very crafty wrestling there.
We see Kennedy with that earlier head kick right on the side of Ebersole's head. We listen in to Steve Kennedy's corner.
At the Melbourne Central Lion Hotel, the official venue of the Hex Fight Series by Get a Little Free at Melbourne Central. Seconds out. This is the final round, the Hex Middleweight World Title on the line.
So here we go for round number three. Three five-minute rounds for the middleweight title, Hex Fight Series 6. This one for all the marbles.
Fighters touch gloves.
And Ebersole and Kennedy, 5 minutes left.
Third and final round.
To decide who gets the belt here at the Melbourne Pavilion after a great night of MMA action.
Ooh. Kennedy's really starting to lift his work right now. He's got a sense of confidence around him. I think he has the feeling that he's got Ebersole's measure here, Stephen.
Kennedy throwing that hook kick just earlier and the oblique kick as well.
Just a little more creativity from Kennedy, a bit more proactive and a bit more creative.
Oh, big shot there from Kennedy.
Gets the stare from the old master.
And a left there from Kennedy. Ebersole going to the body. And a left there from Ebersole, realizing he's got to pick the pace up.
Ebersole's really got to do something big here.
Kick to the body and a left there to Kennedy. They tie up yet again. And Ebersole far more aggressive so far in this third round compared to his previous two.
And attempted trip there from the overhook from Kennedy, working really well here.
So far, Ebersole's lost the grappling side of things. And again,
inside
Kennedy.
Trip from Kennedy.
Third time lucky for Kennedy. And again, Ebersole finds himself on the bottom of Steve Kennedy.
This could be enough, Stephen, to take away the belt.
3.5 minutes remaining here in the fight. And Stephen Kennedy, so far, is that length of time away from taking the Hex middleweight title. Ebersole's got to get out of here and mount some kind of offense because he's behind.
Ebersole really needs to get to his feet here and affect a major strategy on Steve to really affect a finish here, Steve.
Kennedy quite content to sit in the guard of Ebersole.
Kennedy looking to posture up and land some strikes of his own here.
Under 3 minutes left. And Ebersole just being shut down every time he tries to posture up or throw his legs over for a submission. Kennedy just throws the weight right back on him. And really not much Ebersole can do about it at the moment. And again, Kennedy trying to pass. Third appearance at Hex for Stephen Kennedy. Decision win over Rand Weathers and first ever Hex back in December of 2014.
Oh, he's attempting that half mount, which means he's got that knee through. Hasn't quite got the full mount there, but really attempting to get that knee onto the mat, that right knee onto the mat. You can see there, Stephen, he's trying to push that knee through and get a dominant position. Looking at the Kimura now.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen,
Ebersole, 2 minutes left. Kennedy now looking to wrench that arm of Ebersole. Looking to finish this fight.
Ebersole really needs to straighten his arm here. He's done.
He's out. And Kennedy trying to push that leg through.
Such an interesting chess match here, Stephen White. Between two very, very seasoned and experienced fighters.
Kennedy now with short elbows on Ebersole. He'd be content to ride this out for the next 90 seconds. Ebersole's got to get back to his feet, or he's got to do something pretty dramatic from the bottom. He's in a better position than he was moments ago.
Momentum all with Steve Kennedy thus far, Stephen.
And the instructions from Ed Bavelock, he's got to move. Just over a minute remaining here in the Hex middleweight title fight. Third round, Ebersole stuck under Stephen Kennedy. Kennedy now content to rain short shots on top. 1 minute remaining, Ebersole trying to get out from underneath Kennedy. Kennedy just moving his weight forward, keeping the pressure on. Very difficult for Ebersole to get out.
Ebersole really needs to stand up here, Steve.
45 seconds left. Long shot there from Kennedy, trying to step over again. 30 seconds left in the round.
Final 30 seconds.
Kennedy now trying to scoop through the half guard of Brian Ebersole.
Oh, he's past guard there. Inside control now.
And Ebersole's in a pretty bad position, but Kennedy really not looking for the jugular here. 10 seconds remaining in the round. Kennedy pinning Ebersole to the canvas. And that will do it here for the Hex middleweight title. We go to the judges' decision after 15 minutes and three rounds between Kennedy and Ebersole. Steve Kennedy and Ebersole both exhausted after this one. We'll go to the judges' scorecard.
You can see that Steve Kennedy really got the better of the takedowns in this one. I think that was the telling point here. Very, very convincing from Steve Kennedy.
Don't forget the after party will be held at Melbourne Central Line Hotel. Big thank you here to the Summer Tower Punch Champagne City event. Ladbrokes.com.au and Recon Planning.
And let's head down to Perry Kale cage side for the decision. This bout proudly brought to you by Ladbrokes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard. Albert Shen, Shane Byrne, and David DeVersa had it 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision and new Hex middleweight champion of the world, the Steamroller, Stephen Mr. Kennedy.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Stephen the Steamroller Kennedy. Steve, how's this one feel?
Just another day in the office. No, just kidding. You can go away for a bit. I've got a lot to say. Firstly, Brian, thank you. What an honour. We had some problems or whatever, but it's just a stupid industry where you get a lot of he says, she says bullshit, and it's nothing really. I love that guy. I wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for him. But that's my coach, ladies and gentlemen. That's Serge, for anyone wondering. Guys, I know everyone's leaving, but that's the last time you ever see me fight MMA. 100%. Beautiful belt, beautiful trophy. Hopefully they'll let me take it home, but I've done. I had about 10 moments warming up to the fight where I was excited, and about 100 moments of, fuck, I don't want to be here. Why am I doing this? This is the worst idea in the world. I've got a wife at home. I've got shit to do. Brian's in exactly the same boat. He knows that it's not as fun as it used to be when you're in your mid-20s, so I'm glad it ended here at the Melbourne Pavilion, where I probably had my first big wins. And I'm glad it was against this guy who, he basically brought MMA to my side of the world in Perth, so it's pretty fucking epic. And but no disrespect for Brian, but everyone in Western Australia, in my state, my city, that helped him get ready for the fight, fuck you. All right, thank you.
Well, Steve, if this is indeed, we see you the last time in the cage, congratulations on an illustrious career. Enjoy this one, and, well, it's been a long road, but you get to finish on top. Ladies and gentlemen, Stephen the Steamroller Kennedy. All right, I'm here with Brian Ebersole. Brian came out of retirement to take this fight. Give us your evaluation on your performance tonight.
That walkout song that played for both of us was my walkout song, and I didn't live up to it tonight. I retired a year ago amidst a bunch of injuries, and just the feeling of getting older, less explosive. And, you know, Steve gave me a good reason to train and come back. Like you said, we had a training history, and there was that little bit of a disrespect in the fact that he'd even fight me. So that motivated me to train. Glad I had a good opponent to train for. Like I said, he got himself to the UFC on his own accord, and he was coming off that UFC stint for this fight, so I knew it wasn't going to be easy. Trained my butt off, and I guess I'm just not as good once as I ever was, like I thought I could. I thought I could pull it together after a year off and give a bit of a sparkling performance, but came in, felt flat. Steve's a strong kid. I taught him how to wrestle, and he's used it very, very well, and he controlled me pretty well on the ground tonight, so...
So after tonight, what's next for Brian Ebersole?
Having a baby, moving back to my hometown. I haven't been in my hometown since I left for college. I mean, I've been there, but I haven't lived there. So coming back to Bradley, Illinois, going to settle down for a while. Got a house, got a wife, and a newborn on the way. So happily ever after for me.